This is an ingenious Jomeezian creation.
Greetings, immortal souls. Tis I, the great, almighty, and powerful Jomeezius. Now, this video is about how I got to work with Chamillionaire before he quit the rap game. My first major placement, You Must Be Crazy, track 15, on the Ultimate Victory album, 2007. 700,000 records sold. My first one, my first big one. So this is what happened. I started uploading my songs on this website called SoundClick. Okay, this was after I moved out of my parents' house. I was 19 years old. I was renting a room for my sister. Uploading my tracks, banging out tracks every day. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 tracks every day. Posting my stuff up there, man. It's a charting system on this website where the more plays you get, the higher up you are on this chart, on this charting system that they have. It's like a Billboard chart. So the more plays you're getting, the higher up you are, the more traffic you continue to get. So what I did was I started uploading my songs and I would go to the top people, whoever they were, and I'd go to their message boards. This was before, like, it was really comments and shit. This would be like the comment section. It's like MySpace days and shit. So I go to their message boards and I start talking shit. I was like the first original troll, bro. The first one. So I'd be like, hey man, I'm sorry, your music is all right, but I'm the greatest of all time. Everybody come check out my shit, come to my page and see why I'm the greatest motherfucker that's ever done music. That's what I would say. I went to like all the top ones, like the top 50, all on their message boards, and you know what, it worked. All of a sudden, I'm getting calls from everywhere. Boom, 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 everybody calling me. Boom, 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 from all over the world. Transylvania, Australia, Canada, France, Italy, anywhere you can think of, the Philippines, Africa. Everyone wanted a piece of Jomeezius tracks, man. So, fast forward a little bit. David Burke from Pennsylvania calls me for one of my most popular songs at the time. It was called This Is a Man's World, all right? So, I'm getting a lot of plays on this song, and then this dude calls me. He's like, hey, I want to buy the exclusive rights for this song. I'm like, all right, I'll sell it to you for $300. And he goes, how about this? I'll give you $600 for it. I was like, okay. So I got the WAV files together, all the master files. He paid me, I sent the files, sent the paperwork. All right? Simple as that, bada bing, bada boom. So a few months later, I get this email from one of my clients like, yo, I just want to say congratulations and good work on that Chamillionaire joint. I was like, what? What are you talking about? He's like, yeah, that song you produced on the Chamillionaire album, good shit. So I ain't even heard the shit yet. I have no idea what's going on. So I download the album and I get the tracks 15 and it's, This Is a Man's World, now called You Must Be Crazy. And I freaked out. I called my boy. I was like, yo, I done made it, man. KG. That was my partner. I'm like, KG, I made it. My song's on the Chamillionaire album. Lil Wayne about to call me. Everybody about to call me, man. Because Chamillionaire had just won a Grammy on his last album. So I was like, shit, I done made it. I'm over here young as fuck. I'm about to get on just like how I knew I was, you know what I'm saying? But I had to go through a process. You know, I called one of my mentors, Sirocco Jones, who happened to be a producer way back in the day for Motown. And he's been one of the early Jomeezius supporters. So I called him, I was like, yo, I got the situation, blah, blah, blah. This dude that stole my song, he sold it to Chamillionaire, what can I do? So I already knew who it was, obviously, because I know who I sold the tracks to. So he told me to get a lawyer. So I'm calling lawyers, blah, blah, blah. Boom, get one. Because all the rest of them were telling me no. They were like, nah, we're not taking this case. I got one. My lawyer, still talk to him to this day, Wallace Collins Esquire, out of Times Square, New York. If y'all ever need an entertainment attorney, that's the guy, Wallace Collins Esquire. Thank you for all your help, man, and all your support for all the years, man. I appreciate you. But anyways, man, so he had to basically, and you can Google all this shit, man. He had to basically file paperwork with Chamillionaire's people, like a cease and desist or some kind of shit, you know, to let them know that I need to be paid and credited properly for my song. And I saw a video that Chamillionaire put out sometime afterwards where he was like, I didn't know what to do. One producer said they made it, they had the files. The other producer said they made it, and they had the files. I didn't know what to do. So they ended up settling with me for $30,000, man. And then on top of that, I was guaranteed placement on his next album, which was to be called Venom, which never came out. Apparently, he was just done. I don't know if my situation had anything to do with why he left the rap game, but that's really what happened, man. So You know, I seen that he went to Silicon Valley and started working on apps, you know. So, hey, shout out to Chamillionaire. Thank you so much for the opportunity. That guy, David Burke, I see that he still goes to Wikipedia to this day. Let me tell you this. This motherfucker changed his name to Dave the Musical Genius after he stole my credit and stole my song. He tried to steal my whole identity, fam. Like, straight up. I see that he goes to Wikipedia still to this day, and he changes the credit from my name to Dave the Musical Genius. He did not even at any point start to deny the fact that he was not the creator of the song. Like, I was like, I can remake the song. Like, shit, I remember where I was for every single song that I've ever created. I remember exactly what I was feeling, so. So yeah, that's basically, that's the story. So, that was my first major placement, 700,000 sold. Shout out to Chamillionaire. Hey man, no hard feelings. Obviously, I'm the real producer behind it because I continue to go on and I continue to make strides in the music industry, which I'm going to continue to show people so that everyone's aware of my catalog, because I keep releasing new music. I just dropped music for Aliens, you know what I'm saying? Because my music is beyond, you know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like sometimes it's gonna take thousands of years for people to grasp the type of artwork that I create. But that's just me, that's just how I feel. So I feel like when the aliens come and they find me out there and they're just like, you know, checking out our society and they stumble upon Jomeez's, that's when my music will finally be understood. But, you know, I have been shown in my lifetime lots of proof that I actually may see my just due in my lifetime. So I'm just letting you guys know this because I've been treated terribly in the music industry. It's a terrible game, and people have tried to steal my identity. People have tried to take credit for my work. People have tried not to credit me for my work. People have tried to blackball me. There's a lot of haterism going on right now, and I can't understand why. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people that I helped in their career, produced their first singles and everything, gave them, you know, a lot of headway into getting into the music game, you know, in a proper way. You know what I'm saying? I've helped a lot of people, and I've done phenomenal things, and I've created this beautiful catalog of audio portraits that I will continue to share with you guys. I just want to make sure that you guys are aware of the work that I've already done, my more notable works that I've already done, that you might not know that I'm the man behind it. So, much love, I appreciate y'all. Have a wonderful day, stay safe. The boogeyman is outside. Make sure you're wearing gloves, keep your 6 feet away from people, and cover your face up. Deuces.